There we go. Good morning. It is good to see all of you back in person again after a week off, and of course, what a joyous time to be gathered here again as we begin this beautiful season we call Advent. Are there any announcements this morning? One I'll share with you. Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. we'll begin a grief support group here at the church. Any and all are welcome to attend that. It'll be about an hour and a half, but that begins on Tuesday morning. And of course, we have our various Bible studies here in our community at 10 a.m. and at 6 p.m. or 7 p.m. On Wednesday as well. Well, if there are no announcements, I invite us to prepare our hearts, to still our spirits as we begin this day of worship. I want to invite the Whitman family to come and to lead us as we begin this Advent season.
Today is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent means coming, and in this season, we prepare for the coming of Christ. One of the ways we prepare for his coming is by making an Advent wreath and lighting its candles to remind us of the gifts Christ brings to the world. The Advent wreath includes many symbols to help us think about Christ and his gifts. The wreath itself is in the shape of a circle. A circle has no beginning and no end. This reminds us that there is no beginning and no end to God, and that God's love and caring are forever. The light from the candles, which grows stronger each Sunday in Advent, reminds us that Jesus is the light of the world. Today, we light the candle of hope. The people of Israel hoped in God's promises and were not disappointed. Again and again, God delivered Israel from its enemies. We too have the same experience of salvation. That is why we believe in God's promise to send Jesus to us once again to judge the world and establish his kingdom forever upon the earth.
Let us pray. Thank you, God, for the hope you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come true and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your hope with each other. We ask in the name of the one who was born in Bethlehem. Amen.
Dear friends, I invite you to stand as you are able as we begin our opening dialogue found in your bulletins and on the screen. Blessed is he who comes as King, who comes in the name of the Lord. I will hear what the Lord God has to say. peace for all people and for his friends. Help is near for those who fear him. Blessed is he who comes as king, who comes in the name of the Lord. Let us now join together in the Apostles' Creed. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come and judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Stir up your power, O Lord, and come. Protect us by your strength and save us from the threatening dangers of our sins. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Friends, you may be seated. And as you are seated, I will invite the children to come and to join with me. You look confused. Whew, oh my, there's a lot of you today. Well, hello there. How are you? You remember this from last year? How are you? Okay, here's the question I bet all of you know the answer to. How many days until Christmas?
27.
That's pretty close. Do you want to see? I have a clock on my computer that tells me how many days, hours, and minutes. Anyone know how many hours?
No.
You don't know? You don't know? Anyone want to guess?
It's probably like
100 hours. It's close. It's 26 days. 14 hours, 19 minutes, and 1 second. Well, now 0 seconds. Now 18 minutes and 59 seconds. 57 seconds, 56.
It's hard.
Yeah, it is. Look at that. See, I have a clock. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, yeah. You guys want to see?
Wait,
what do you think?
So, what does 44 mean?
44? Oh, that's how many seconds are left. Do you want to see over here? That's when Christmas is coming. You like that? I have to go on this side. Do y'all want to see too? There it is. So for parents, this is how many days left you have. Just, you know, Santa's coming, so you all better be ready. There you go. That's how many days till Santa comes. Oh, is that exciting? Who else comes on this day? Who else comes on this day? Yeah. Yeah, God will come on this day too, isn't he? That's exciting. Yeah. So who's ready for Christmas?
Me.
You ready?
She
has a birthday right after Christmas too. Oh, she's lucky. She gets Christmas and her birthday. How exciting. So are you ready for Christmas? Yeah. Are you guys ready for Christmas? How do we get ready for Christmas? You have to get your Christmas stuff up? Your elf is in, oh, that's right. Elf comes this time of year too, doesn't he? Yeah. Yeah. So we also have to get ready for something else on Christmas too, don't we? And you guys all said who's coming? Santa, but who else for Jesus, right? For baby Jesus, because he's going to come too, isn't he? Well, yes, we have to get carrots for the reindeer too, don't we? But where'd my calendar go? So in 26 days, we have to be ready for Jesus, right? Because he's going to come. Because he is our gift from God, isn't he? And he's a special gift, isn't he? He's the best gift we're going to receive at Christmas. So we have to get ready for him, which means we have to hold him in our hearts, don't we? We have to hold him in our hearts, and we have to give thanks to God for baby Jesus, okay? Okay? So let's say a prayer, guys. Okay? So fold our hands, close our eyes, and let's get ready for Jesus. Dear God, thank you for Jesus. Thank you for loving us and giving us this gift. Let us prepare our hearts for baby Jesus. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Morning. The first lesson is from Jeremiah chapter 33. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at the time I will cause a righteous branch to spring up from David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days Judah will be saved and Jerusalem will live in safety, and this is the name by which it will be called. The Lord is our righteousness. Second lesson is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 3. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy that we feel before God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you face to face and restore whatever is lacking in your faith. Now may God and our Father himself and our Lord Jesus direct our way. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. And may he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. Here ends the reading.
Friends, I invite you to stand as you are able. As we hear our gospel lesson this morning from the Gospel of St. Luke in the 21st chapter, hear these words from verse 25 through 36. There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on the earth distress among nations confused by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world. For the powers of heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming on a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to take place, stand up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. Then he told them a parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on guard so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, for that day does not catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated, my friends. Well, here we are. The first Sunday in Advent. We begin this journey with the very question that must be asked. Are you also ready? We heard our children, they're very ready for Christmas to arrive. Are you ready? It's hard to believe, isn't it? The end of November. We're about to enter into December. We're in the season of Advent, the season of preparing ourselves for the arrival of Christ. And so Jesus asks the very question, are you ready? Are you ready for his arrival? But there's also a second question that is posed, which is, are you ready for his return? We know the story of the birth of Jesus. We know his death and resurrection. And we also, in truth, know that one day he shall return, as promised this morning in our text. Watch and be ready. It's a simple thing that sounds on the surface to just prepare yourselves. But here's Christmas coming around the corner. And isn't it true for a lot of us, or at least some of us, that that day, Christmas morning, will happen and the real question will be, why did it show up so fast? I'm convinced this year it came quicker than ever before. The truth is, it's the same day every year. The last I checked, at least on my calendar, they haven't changed Christmas Day just yet. And in fact, here's a crazy thought. The days between when Christmas happened last year and the coming Christmas, it's the same amount of time frame. Unless we're in a leap year and then we had a little more time just to give ourselves a little break. But the truth is, it happens the same way. And so why then do we find ourselves unprepared for when Christmas shows up? In fact, if you watch the news, it gave dire warnings. You better get ready early this year because there may not be as much stuff to buy in the stores because of supply chain issues. But yet, we've known Christmas was coming for a whole year. But you know, Jesus asked a more important question, I think, today. And that, are you ready for his return? Or maybe a better question yet is, are you ready for that moment that you will meet Christ again? Because here's something that we all know, we may not admit it, but we all know there will come a day when we all will meet our Savior. It is promised, it is guaranteed that our time on earth, our time here, is finite. We will not be here permanently. There's an old story, and from what I remember of it, and I remember hearing this many, many, many years ago, but it goes something like this. Satan was holding a convention with all of his angels, and the goal of this convention was to try and determine how to convince those who had Christ in their hearts to walk away from him. And all sorts of ideas were proposed. All sorts of thoughts. Well, we'll go to earth and we'll tell everyone that the Bible is just a myth. It's a very nice story, but it really isn't true. Satan would say to these ideas, you know, those are all really good ideas, but you know, I have a better one. Why not just be direct? Why not just tell them that God does exist, the Bible is true, but you don't have to worry about it anytime soon, because you got lots of time to prepare, lots of time to ready yourself. He says, let's just tell them to just put it on the back burner for a while, focus on yourself, and you can eventually get to God when you have more time. Now, the crazy thought about that old story is it's a little true, isn't it? All of us think to ourselves, I have lots of time before I'll meet Christ. I got plenty of time to read my scriptures and study that word and pray and learn how to really devote myself to following Christ in the world. So I got plenty of time to get to that. I've got to worry about these other things right now, because that's what's on my plate and my relationship with Christ. I can get to that eventually because I got lots of time. But we all know that isn't true, because at any moment, any of us, any single one of us in this room or watching online might be standing before our Creator. In that very moment, we might then ask ourselves, look, God, I know I'm here, but could you give me maybe a couple days to get ready for this? Could you give me a couple hours to prepare myself? I know I'm coming to meet you, Lord, but just give me some more time. And God will say, no, now is the time. So how much time do we need? Jesus, in this scripture this morning, in this gospel lesson, clearly states, you all know that's coming. I have given you signs of the creation and what is to come. And we know, as they did not know, but we know the whole story, don't we? We know that his death and his resurrection and his ascension occurred. We saw it all, we see it all. And we know that there is a promise, even if we don't fully understand it yet, that Christ will come back. But are we getting ready for that very moment that that occurs? We don't know the date. We don't know the time. All we know is with certainty, he will return. And the truth is, we know with certainty, 100% certainty, that you will stand before him. And it's my hope and prayer for you, and even for me, that the words that are echoed by Jesus as he looks upon me will be, well done, good and faithful servant. Well done, good and faithful servant. Which means I have to prepare myself, just as all of us do, for that faithful day. That joyous day in which we see the face of Christ. Now, Jesus isn't telling us in this passage that, hey, you need to stop everything you're doing in this world and just fully focus on me. There's a balance, I think, that we must do. We can't cut ties with everyone that's around us. We can't walk away from everything. We must balance our responsibilities in this world as a light into this world with our responsibility to grow in our relationship with Jesus. That's what this light is about on this candle. This light which God sends into the world as his son, which is the hope that, guess what? All is not lost yet. You may not be close to Christ today, yet the good news is you have time. I just can't tell you how much that time is. But it is the hope of this light that is in you. It is the hope that if you start right now in this very moment saying to yourself, I'm going to work on this relationship with Jesus. I'm going to work on all that I must do, that as I live in this life, my focus will be first on Christ and then all the blessings that He gives to me. And I'm going to work on that day in and day out. Why? Because God has called me to love thy neighbor as thyself, to share the gospel with all of the world. Because what happens if you are the hope for someone? What happens if you are the voice into someone's life, and for whatever reason you think to yourself, I have plenty of time to share the grace that God has for them, and you think to yourself, I'll do it next week. I'll do it when it feels right, and that time never comes. You've missed a great opportunity, haven't you? This is what Jesus is warning, both those that are hearing of Him and of us today. There is a hope that Christ will come. There is a hope that when you stand before your Creator, He will say, well done, good and faithful servant. So let's prepare ourselves for that gift. Let's prepare ourselves this Advent season, for it is an opportunity given to us all. Let's not squander that. Let's not abandon that message. Friends, I want to invite you to stand as you are able as we sing this beautiful hymn, number 294, My Hope is Built on Nothing Less. You may be seated, friends. In this season of watching and waiting, let us pray for all people and places that yearn for God's presence. God, have presence and peace. Strengthen your church around the globe to proclaim the message of your love coming into the world. Open our hearts to recognize your face in all people and in all creation. Hear us, O God. God of mighty redwoods and microscopic plants, fields and city parks, the wind and the waves, be a healing balm to our wounded planet. May we nurture what you have lovingly created. Hear us, O God. God of equity and compassion, bring righteousness and goodness to all peoples of the earth. Give a heart of discernment and integrity to leaders in our community. Hear us, O God. God of comfort and care, be present with those who watch and wait. Come to all who await birth, death, divorces, new unions, new jobs, retirements, healing, and life transformations of every kind, especially Doris, Mona, Louis, Dolores, Sue, the Swieford family, Lee, Esther, Phil, Jeff and Lisa, Kay, Wanda, Karen, Stephanie, Mitchell, Janine, Tom, Ken, and the Deemer family. Hear us, O God. God of promises kept and new dreams awakened, shelter your people from destructive storms. We pray for those whose lives have been upended by natural disasters, for the work of the Lutheran Disaster Response, Lutheran World Relief, and other relief organizations. Hear us, O God. God of companionship and community, we give you thanks for the saints who've journeyed with us and now abide in you. Even in distress and uncertainty, make us confident in your promises endured forever. Hear us, O God. God of new life, you come among us in the places we least expect. Receive these prayers and those of our hearts in the name of Jesus. Amen. And now may we join together the prayer that he taught us by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may the Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look upon us with favor and give us peace. Amen. I invite you now to stand as you are able as we sing hymn 35, Hark the Glad Sound. So now, go in peace and serve the Lord.